The Nobel Peace Laureates and Peace Laureate Organization gathered in Rome for the 14th World Summit of Nobel Peace Laureates from 12 to 14 December 2014 to honor the legacy of Nelson Mandela and to consider current threats to peace and global security. They expressed their sadness that they were not able to honor Nelson Mandela and his fellow peace laureates in Cape Town this year because of the refusal of the South African government to grant a visa to His Holiness the Dalai Lama. They voiced their deep concern about the growing threat of war, including nuclear war between large states. This threat arises from the continuing view of some great powers that they can achieve their goals through military force. If left unchecked, this tendency will inevitably lead to increased military confrontation and to a new and more dangerous Cold War. The conflict in Ukraine is threatening the stability of Europe and is undermining its capacity to play a positive role in the world. The events in the Middle East are taking an increasingly dangerous turn. There are existing a smothering conflict in many parts of the world, particularly in Syria, Iraq, Israel, Palestine, Afghanistan, South Sudan, and Ukraine. Another serious threat to peace is fanaticism in the guise of religion. The Nobel Peace Laureates emphasize that no creed or religious belief should be perverted to justify gross violation of human rights or the abuse of women and children. At the same time, the world continues to be threatened by 16,000 nuclear weapons and military expenditure last year of $1.7 trillion. The Nobel Peace Laureate endorsed Pope Francis' recent call for nuclear weapons to be banned once and for all, and urged all states to commence negotiation on a treaty to eliminate nuclear weapons at the earliest possible time. The Nobel Peace Laureate warned against the threat of new autonomous killer robotic weapons and demand an immediate halt to the use of indiscriminate weapons. They called on all states to join the Mine Ban Treaty, the Convention on Cluster Munitions and Arms Trade Treaty. However, the Nobel Peace Laureates believe that military conflict is not the only threat to human security. Human beings are threatened by global warming, climate change, and the degradation of our ecosystems. The plight of 10 million stateless people and 50 million refugees and displaced persons. The continued abuse of children and violence against women and girls, including sexual violence by armed groups in conflict situations. Unacceptable poverty in which more than 2 billion people live on less than $2 per day, and unsustainable levels of unemployment, particularly amongst the youth population. The Nobel Peace Laureate called upon religious, business, civic leaders, parliaments, and all persons of goodwill to work for effective policies to address these threats. We must do all we can to reverse these dangerous trends. We need substantive ideas and proposals that will help the current generation of political leaders to overcome the severe crisis of international relations, restore normal dialogue, and create institutions and mechanisms that fit the needs of today's world. The summit was attended by 10 Nobel Peace Laureates and 12 Nobel Peace Laureate organizations. His Holiness the Dalai Lama, Dr. Shireen Ibadi, Mrs. Tawafu Kama, Mrs. Maureen McGuire, President Joseph Ramos Horta, Lord William David Tremble, Mrs. Betty Williams, Jody Williams, American Friends Service Committee, Amnesty International, European Commission International Campaign to Ban Landmines, International Labour Organization, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, International Peace Bureau, International Physicians Petition for the Prevention of Nuclear War, Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, Pugwash Conferences on Science and World Affairs, United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, United Nations, and myself, Lehman Bowie. Thank you.